Talo for lover and hello. And it's good to be back in Parliament, first week of July, and it's our last week before recess, our July recess. And still focus for me here is chairing the Social Services Committee and putting through the legislation around the Housing Accords Bill, which is particularly important, not just to Auckland, but New Zealanders, where we will be releasing large, substantial packages of land for development, for residential purposes, and that will take place hopefully at the end of the year when the accord is signed and when the unitary plan is notified and we can get on with building more houses in Auckland. Affordable housing, of course, is a big issue, certainly in my electorate, but across Auckland and New Zealand, and that's why this bill is important for us to construct more houses, get people into warmer, drier homes, and bring down the house of pricing across the country. Yesterday in the electorate, I had the real privilege of officiating over my first citizenship ceremony. And it was for an Iraqi woman who has been here for about a decade, and it was quite a joyous occasion where her family and friends were there to signify a big step for her in becoming a New Zealand citizen. And you know, it symbolises who we are as New Zealanders, our citizenship, our shared values, our common norms that we share as Kiwis. And it's a big step to become a New Zealander, and she was certainly proud to take that step. And you know, certainly as a migrant myself, I understand the importance of citizenship in that it's a step towards taking your place in our society in New Zealand. And also just what it means in terms of the sacrifice that many have made for this country, that we can enjoy the freedoms and the liberties of living and working and residing in New Zealand. Last Friday in the electorate, I went to the Royal Oak Art Auction, Royal Oak Primary School Art Auction, and that was really neat. It's really a time for parents and friends of the school to join with the teachers and the staff to have an art auction and also raise money for the school and the pupils at the school. So again, thousands were raised on the night, and I'm still waiting to hear back from the school whether I won another piece in the silent auction. So I look forward to receiving that piece. On Saturday I was at Ferguson Park in Te Papa, where Te Papa Onehunga played against the university team at senior level. Sadly, they lost 33-27, and the women lost to East Tamaki 65-5. But it was a great day out amongst the locals, enjoying the football, the rugby. And we had a couple of super rugby stars. Taniela Moore was playing for the local team, and so you know, there was certainly a lot of running rugby, and really enjoyed my day out at Te Papa Onehunga Rugby Football Club. But yeah, it's another busy week before recess. There's a number of bills on the agenda. The Convention Centre bill will be read for the first time this Thursday afternoon, and I look forward to talking about that bill at first reading, particularly around the jobs that will be created, the $90 million in extra revenue that will be generated for the economy. The 1,000 jobs that are created in construction, but the 900 jobs going forward. Opportunities for local people to take up employment and look after their families, and that's particularly important in an economy that is steadily growing, and I'm proud of the national government and how we've you know, really developed the economy, and we're growing, and certainly I feel it in the feedback that I'm getting from the electorate. So that Convention Centre legislation will be going through the House as of Thursday. And later on Friday I'm going to Smoke-Free Pacific Beats. It's really a celebration of bands and talents and gifts of young people who come together to celebrate their musical talents, their singing and dancing, and I'm certainly looking forward to handing out one of the awards on Friday night. And I'm looking forward to recess and certainly coming back here in August for more of Parliament from me. But until then, I look forward to either seeing you in the electorate or hearing from you through my electorate office. But I wish you well and enjoy the beautiful weather that's out there at the moment in Wellington across the country.